helps the voiceless creature. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, The Vet Tutorial. Today we are going to study about the osteological terms, and it is important before studying the bones in detail. So let's first see what is osteology. Osteology deals with the component of skeletons. So skeleton can be defined as a hard framework of body which supports soft structures. This is composed of bones, cartilage and ligament. And bones are the principal component of the skeleton. Then let's study about the functions of skeleton. It supports the whole body and gives accommodation and protection to vital organs in thorax, pelvis and skull. Second, it provides attachment to the muscles. Third, it is a basic structure for movement. Fourth, it accommodates blood-forming tissues like bone marrows. Fifth, it is a storehouse of salts and minerals for future utilization. Sixth, since the components of skeleton have their growth and death, it is a dynamic and living structure. Skeleton is divided into two parts, axial and appendicular. The axial skeleton comprises of the bones of skulls, vertebral column, ribs and sternum, and the appendicular skeleton is made up of bones of limbs. Then let's start with the osteological terms. First is process. It is any projection or prominence of the bone. Then head. It is a rounded articular prominence found at the end of the bone. It is jointed to the shaft by a narrow constricted portion called as neck. Example found in humerus and femur. Here the articular means something related to joints and non-articular means using or involving muscles rather than joints. Then condyle. It is a cylindrical articular prominence found at the end of the bone. Example found in humerus and femur. Then tubercle. It is a small, blunt, non-articular prominence. Example found in scapula and humerus. Then fifth is tuberosity. It is the same feature as tubercle, but it is larger than tubercle. Example found in humerus, radius, metacarpal and tibia. Then trochanter. It has same feature as tuberosity, but it is larger than tuberosity. Example found in femur. Then spine. It is either a rounded ridge-like elevation or a pointed non-articular projection. Example found in scapula. Then crest. It is a sharply raised ridge which is non-articular. Example found in tibia and coxae. Then line. It is a small linear elevation, that is the raised area is very small and it is non-articular. Example found in scapula and coxae. Then epicondyle. It is non-articular prominence associated with the condyle. Example found in humerus. Then trochlea. It is a pulley-like articular depression or depressed area. Example found in humerus and femur. Then glenoid cavity. It is a shallow cup-like articular depression. Example found in scapula. Then cotyloid cavity or acetabulum. It is more deeper cup-like articular depression. Example found in coxae. Then facet. It is a small articular depressed area. Example found in the side of body of thoracic vertebra for the attachment of head of the ribs. Then fovea. It is a shallow articular depression. Example found in neural rings of atlas, also known as fovea dentis. Then fossa. It is non-articular depression. Example found in scapula, humerus and femur. Then sulcus, sulci or grooves. It is a shallow or deep grooved area or elongated depression. Example found in humerus and radius. Then foramen. It is perforation in the bone for transmission of vessels, nerves, etc. Example found in skull, scapula, humerus and femur. Then hiatus. It is a depression leading to two or more foramina. Example found in diaphragm. then cornus. It is a curved horn-like process, example found in skull, frontal bone, hyoid bone. Then fissure. It is a small slit-like area, example found in skull, palatine. Then notch. It is a small cut area, example in scapula, in glenoid notch, and in oxcoxae, ischiatic notch. Here we end the osteological terms, but before ending the video, let's see the compiled version of that. Basically, I made a table which includes a bone area, form joints or not, osteological term, shape and example. In bone area section, first is prominent, then articular and non-articular. Articular, the osteological term includes head, and its shape is round. An example is humerus and femur. Then, second osteological term under articular is condyle. Its shape is cylindrical. An example is femur. Then, in non-articular, first osteological term is tubercle, and its shape is small. An example is humerus, under which sauce tubercle. Then, second osteological term is tuberosity. Shape is bigger than tubercle, example is humerus, under that lateral, medial and deltoid. Then third is trochanter, and its shape is bigger than the tuberosity, example femur, under which trochanter major and minor. Then fourth is spine, and its shape is ridge-like elevation, example scapula, under which scapular spine. Then fifth is crest. Its shape is sharply raised in ridge, example humerus, under which deltoid crest, lateral epicondyloid crest, then oxcoxa, ischial crest. Then sixth is line. Its shape is small linear elevation, example scapula, rough lines and ilium, gluteal lines. Then second in bone area is depression. First is articular. Osteological term trochlea, shape is pulley-like, example humerus and femur. Second osteological term is glenoid cavity, shape is shallow cup-like and example is scapula. Third osteological term under articular is cotyloid cavity, shape is deep cup-like and example is oscoxae. Then facet, and its shape is small area-like, example vertebra. Then fovea, its shape is shallow depression-like, an example is atlas, fovea dentis. Then non-articular, example fossa, deep depression-like shape is there, and example is scapula, in which subscapular fossa, and humerus, in which radial and olecranon fossa. Then sulci or sulcus. Its shape is small elongated, an example is tibia, under which sulcus muscularis. And lastly, grooves, and its shape is elongated area, example is radius. Stay safe and let's meet in the next video.